Hello people, my name is Ferdy, and in this tutorial I will show you how you can create a form in your WordPress website using an AI form builder. So what you do, you create a prompt and type out what kind of form you want to have, hit enter, and that form will be created using the tool called SureForms. It's a free plugin, there's also a pro version, but let's take a look at how you can get the free version and how everything works. In order to make use of SureForms, we go to ferdy.com/SureForms, hit enter. And in this case, we'll be redirected to the beta form. But I have great news for you. Instead, you can go to the backend of your WordPress website, go to plugins, add new plugin, and search for SureForms. There it is. At this moment, 500 installations. It's a new plugin. It's from the same makers of the Astra theme, and Sure Triggers, and Card Flows. So I click on Install now, and I click on Activate. And now we can start to create our first form. So I click over here on this button, create a form, create a new form. And then we can choose between two options. I can build one from scratch, and I can build one with AI. Well, let me show you what is possible with AI. So I click over here. Now I just have to tell what I want the form to have. So I say, I want people to fill in their first and last name, leave their phone number, email address, and they have to comply with the GDPR rules. I click on generate form. And now the form will be built. And there it is. It shows me the first name, the last name, my phone number, email address, and the GDPR compliance. So I just had to write it. Now it's there. So I can click on publish. I can take a look over here. It will look like this. First name, last name, phone number, and email address. So let's see if it's working. First name, last name, my phone number. Email address. I am compliance with this, and I click on submit. Thank you. You heard from us. Please be sure to whitelist the email address from me, from this website. So now I'll go to my email account. And there it is, a new form submission. Ferdy, Korpershoek, phone number, email address, and GDPR compliant. So that's how easy it is. Another great feature within this beautiful free plugin is that you have entries in your website. So when people fill in a form, it doesn't only go to your email account, it will also be stored in your website. Let me show you where. Now if I go to my website, I close this, and I go to SureForms. Look at this, I can take a look at the entries. So it's really nice. I see all the entries from people that send me a message. So if I remove this message later on, I can go back to my website and I see all the messages that are here. So I click over here. And there I see all the information that is filled in by this viewer that wants to get in touch with me. So we've created this form using AI, but let me show you how you can adjust this form. I want to go back to the forms. So I click over here. And if I click over here, I can change the title, of course. So I can call this one contact form 7, just kidding, contact form. And over here I can change things. So I can click over here. Really easy, make it 50%. And if I make the one below also 50%, it automatically goes to the right place next to the first name. Over here, if I want to adjust this, so I want to first have the email address, I just click here. If I don't want to make this mandatory, I can uncheck required. And here I can change the help text. So it's very obvious that if I say phone number, that people don't need to have extra explanations, so I can get rid of it. Also over here, that way I can make the form a bit cleaner. Like that. Save it. So that looks better. Right now, I want to ask you to like this video. If you like it, feel free to subscribe for more upcoming tutorials and say something nice to someone else today. If you meet someone, maybe you know the person, maybe you don't, just say something nice. I want to challenge you. Why not? Hey. since we're here, let's continue with the tutorial. What I want to do right now, I forgot. I want to talk about more elements you can add to your form. So let's talk about that. If I want to add things, I click over here, browse them all, and these are the fields you can add. So a text field, people can leave their email, a URL. So I can say hpsyourwebsite.com and the help text if you want to bring it up a bit. So click on the plus, browse all, text area, multiple choice, checkbox, GDPR agreement. People can fill in a number, their phone number. There's a drop down feature. So if I use that one, I can double click. How did you find us? And then over here, I can have a few options. So option one is Google, YouTube. I can add another option, friends, or hotmail models.com. So let's save it and take a look. And then over here, how did you find us? Google, YouTube, friends, hotmail models. We can make it mandatory, required. We can have people select multiple options and people can even search over here. Well, that's not necessary, only four options. So if you click on the plus, browse all, here are all the things. People can fill in their address. You can create a custom button, have a separator, show a heading to keep some structure in your form if it's longer, and show an image and an icon. And if you scroll down, look at this, you can unlock more features with the pro version. But if you click on it, it's not there yet. So I hope when you watch this, it will be visible. So right now there's no pro version yet. They're working on it, but I think the free version can do a lot of things. You can also speed up your workflow with the action menu. At the left hand area of your website, there is a action bar with a lot of elements that you can add to your form by just clicking on it. So let me show you how to use that and how to adjust it so you can speed up your workflow. Over here at the left, you have a few shortcuts. I can add a text, as you see, an email field, text area, checkbox, number. They all appear over here below each other. And it's built on top of the WordPress editor Gutenberg. So I can click over here and delete it, or use this one. Let me see. Shift Command Z, Shift Option Z. Okay. And then over here, you can have shortcuts to the action bar. So maybe you're going to use the address all the time. You can add it over here and then you click on it and it will be added. You can also rearrange it. So text, address, email, like that. So that's a nice shortcut bar, action bar. I click on save. You can also create a form from scratch. Let me show you how. So again, I go to new. I can build one from scratch. And then you get the same thing and then you can start from nothing. So text, email, address, heading, text area. I should have a button over here. So let me see a button. There you go. So that way I can create a form quite fast. You can embed your form into your website and you can have a special dedicated form page. It's called an instant form. Let me show you how to adjust it to your wishes. Let me go back to the first form. We could open it like this and then I can share this form, ferdy.com form, user information form. But I can also embed this. So if I create a new page, contact, publish. Now I can go over here, / search for sure. And then I see form. I can select the form, the contact form, choose. And now it is embedded in my website. Like that. Of course, I need to adjust the style so it's not that wide, but it's something I have to do within the theme. But that's how you can embed this in your website. There are some basic SureForms settings, so let's take a look at those. And then we can also scroll down and go to the settings. So, general. If this option is turned on, the user's IP address will be saved with the form data, if you want that. Enable a honeypot security. I like that. So people need to do something in order to make sure they're really a human. So I will turn this on. Automatically it's saved. I go to validations. Here are all the error messages. You can change those. So if you work in a different language, you can adjust it over here. Let's go to email. Enable email summaries. So all the forms that will be sent to this email address. I can have a report every Monday or every Tuesday or every day I want. I can send a test email summary. So let's do that. And there it is already. See how your forms performed last week? Well, no entries yet. So it's calculating at the end of the day. Spam protection. You can use reCAPTCHA, turnstile and hCAPTCHA. If you want to learn how, go to YouTube and search for reCAPTCHA WordPress form. You should be able to add that. And then there are integrations, webhooks. And in order to use that, you need to have the pro version, which is not out yet. Also here, you can upgrade to the pro version. So, I think this is an amazing form. You can embed it into your website, use a prompt to create the form, and you can see all the entries over here. We already looked at the instant form. I want to configure it even further. So let me show you how you can configure the instant form to your wishes. If I go back to the form and I click over here on view, it looks like this. And what I don't like is this over here, user information form. So I want to click on edit form. I also want to change the color, a few other things. In order to do that, I click on instant form. I scroll down all the way. And here I can change the URL. So I click over here. I can call this one contact form. Click somewhere else. Then there's the background color of the upper area. I can make it darker. I can use a color of my website or any color I want to use. I can add a logo. So if I search for Ferdy, use this one, enable the instant form, save it. Now, if I click over here, the color changed. So how about I change the logo to a light one? Like that. Save it, refresh. Ferdy.com, contact form, first name, last name. I like it. I could change the color. So since I use this, let me copy that. Then I go to the submit button. Form, style, primary color, this one. And one more thing, here at the general, I want to use labels as placeholders. So look at this. It will make the form a bit smaller. Refresh. That's what I prefer. I love it. With a free tool. Oh yeah, the logo is quite big, so I should go over here. Get rid of it. It's unnecessary. Refresh contact form. I love it. We already talked about the general settings, but I also want to take a look at the form settings. For every specific form, there are settings. So let's go through those. So, few more important things we should cover over here. If we go to form, general, we already said use labels as placeholder, but here are a few important settings. Let's take a look at those. Form confirmations. So when people fill in this form, what should happen when they click on submit? Well, I can send a success message. I can adjust it over here. I can hide the form when people submit, or I can reset it. I prefer to hide it and then show this message. You can add things over here. Have a great day. Cheers, Ferdy. Do whatever you want to do, and you can add short codes. So here's a few things you can do. So you can say, hey, first name, we've received your email. So that's what we can do. You can redirect them to a certain page on your website. So you can create a thank you page that has a video like, thank you for filling out this form. Thank you for getting in touch with us. Or redirect them to a custom URL. So somewhere external on a different website. Then if you click over here, that's the same thing as this option over here, email notification. So I click here and now I can go to email notification. That's the second one over here. So I get an email with the title new form submission. So if I go to my email, it says new form submission. So I can click over here. The name is from Ferdy.com. Send an email to my email address, the admin email, or a specific email. I prefer to use the admin email. And here I can say form submission from Ferdy.com. I want to show all data, so I leave it as it is, but you can also say first name and then insert the short code of the first name, last name, etc. And in that way, you fill in all the information. I prefer to have all the data and it will look like this. I scroll down, advanced fields. I can send a BCC to the sender. What I prefer, go back. I can copy this and then adjust it. Name matches at Ferdy.com. Send this not to the admin email, but to the email address. I say your form submission at Ferdy.com. And I can say, hey, first name, thank you for reaching out. We will get in touch with you within 48 hours. Cheers, Ferdy. Reply to the admin email. Okay. Then the compliance settings. When this is enabled, this form will not store user IP, browser name, and device name. You can play around with those settings. I turn them off. There are integrations. You can link this with Sure Triggers, also from the makers of Sure Forms. And in that way, link this to Zapier and a lot of other tools. And you can add custom CSS to style the form if you want to. I save everything. So let's check it out. I click over here. My first name is George. My second name, Washington. Let's say Ferdy. Korpershoek@gmail.com. My phone number. It's not mandatory, so I can also leave this. My website, HTTPS, Ferdy. Korpershoek.com. I check this. Submit. And I will be redirected to the thank you page. And now if I go to the email of the admin of this website, I get this. And the people that sent the message gets this. Hey George, thank you for reaching out. We'll get in touch with you within 48 hours. Details. And cheers, Ferdy. If I click on reply, it will go to the admin email. So everything is working. So now it's a matter of creating forms and embedding them in your website. And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. I think this is an amazing form builder. If you are familiar with Contact Form 7, you have to do everything manually, type things and do a little bit of coding. But with this tool, you just write what you want to have and then it will be created. And it's really easy to adjust. It's built on top of the WordPress editor. Whatever you think about it, I think that's a good thing. And thank you for watching this tutorial. Feel free to like the video and subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. And I also teach about affiliate marketing, about creating your own webshop, everything with the goal to help people to create a website and make money with that website. Having said that, I wish you a great day and the best in all you are doing. Ciao.